It still is.
Not only did she rehang the picture of the Prime Minister upside down that day, she also seduced Walter. He called in after his hygiene class, came bowling up the passage with his book, pens and pencils in a plastic bag, intending to have it out with Anita the Hun, but he was ambushed. Didn't stand a chance. From the second he laid eyes on her, standing there on my kitchen chair, hanging the ex-Prime Minister, he was helpless. She got down and stood there in front of him, shining like a lorikeet, blue eyes and blue uniform, the thick eyeliner, hair electric, and her scent mixed with my homely roast chicken atmosphere. I said, "This is Anita, Walter, the new home help, the one with the list." Anita held her hand out, smiling in her seductive way. But Walter was paralysed, his mouth hanging open. I wanted to put my finger under his bottom lip to prop it up. She said, "How are you, Walter?" And Walter wiped his hand on his footy jumper and shook her hand, saying,
"I've never been better in my life."
At the time, I thought she was better than those Diana Dawes blondes, mostly card girls, who used to hang off Walter. In the newspaper photos, there was always at least one buxom tart under his arm, smiling under a rigid platinum thatch, eyes like boot polish brushes. Pat used to be a platinum blonde in the 60s, and look at her now. Bald.